It doesn't matter how it looks. It doesn't matter how it looks. Let me touch your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
It doesn't matter how it looks.
It doesn't matter.
God will come through.
God will come through.
See, you have to know this. You have to have confidence in the finished work of Jesus Christ, that after you pray, you can go into thanksgiving and give God thanks and glorify God for the things He already did. Amen. Hallelujah. And so when folks asking you, come on, it's been done. It's finished. Yes, it's finished. My God already take care of that. Glory be to God. I just thank God for everything. God already take care of that. Amen. God already take care of that. Amen. I'm telling you, once we have faith in the finished work of Jesus Christ, whatever Jesus has finished and accomplished for you and for me, through faith we receive it. Amen. By faith you receive it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Not work for it. You receive it by faith. Not by works. You receive it by faith. Not by works. Amen. We work and then we get tired. Amen. Y'all know how we get. Because if it's by works, you will get tired. That's why it got to be by faith and not by works. Lest any man. Amen. That means your own capability bring it to pass. And then you ain't going to give God the glory. You'll give yourself the glory. You say, me. It's my dedication. It's what I've been doing. No, it ain't nothing. No, it is what Jesus Christ has already did. And all you did is, let's go to Job chapter 22 and verse 27 and 28. Job 22 and verse 27 and 28. This is what you do. Job chapter 22 and verse 27 and 28. You see that? And thou shalt make that prayer unto who?
Jesus.
So you got to make your prayer unto Jesus. Amen. Read.
And he shall hear thee.
And he shall hear. Oh God, that's good.
Amen.
What the Bible says? He shall what? So when you make your prayer unto him, he's going to what?
Hear thee.
And what are you going to hear?
And thou shalt pay thy vow.
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt also decree a thing.
Uh-huh.
And it shall be established.
Do you agree in a thing?
And the light shall shine upon thy ways.
Amen. He said, if you decree a thing, it shall be established. But whatever you decree, it must be based on what he decreed, right?
Amen.
Must be based on the word. Amen. You can't decree nothing that is not in the word. And so, Lord, we are praying this prayer. Lord, if it be thy will, because we're not too sure that God can answer that prayer. So we got to say, and we ain't sure if it's his will. So we say, Lord, if it be your will, let this be done. Amen. And I know where we get that from. We get that from right from the man, the leopard. When Jesus came down and the leopard, right there says, if it be thou will, make me cleanse. If it be thou will. Because the leopard didn't know that was his will to heal. It is God's will to heal you. Amen. You just have to have faith. And having faith means that you got to have the word. Faith is confidence in the finished work of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. So your confidence is this what? In the finished work of Jesus Christ. Your confidence is in the finished work of Jesus Christ. It's finished. So my confidence as well. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay. Let's go to Isaiah 12 and verse 4. Isaiah 12, 4. It's in the finished work of Jesus Christ. I don't care how it look. I don't care how it looks since of God. We don't live according to how it looks. We live by faith. The Bible says the just shall live by faith. And the Bible says, the just shall live by his faith.
Amen.
That means that's how you're going to live. You can live by your faith. Amen. You can live by your faith. Amen. Not by what you see, not by what they say, but what Jesus Christ has already accomplished for you.
And in that day, shall you praise the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Call upon his name.
Uh-huh.
Declare his doing.
You hear that? You do it right here. He says now, on that day, shall you walk? Shall you walk? Shall praise his name. Someone say the name.
Name.
Jesus, and do what? After praising him, and do what?
Declare his doings.
So you got to know what Jesus already did for you. If you are going to declare his doings, you got to know what Jesus already did for you. That's why you got to know the word. You have to have some knowledge of the word of God in prayer.
Among the people mentioned that his name is excellent.
The name of Jesus is excellent.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm telling you, amen. There's no other name that is given unto us whereby we are saved. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So we need to wake up in the morning declaring the name of Jesus. Let's not declare the name of Jesus, oh God. Yes, the name of the Lord is the world. And the righteous when they are in and they are saved. Start declaring the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. You can't lose when you start declaring the name of Jesus. You can't lose. Amen.
Amen.
You only can win. Okay? Let's go to St. John 16. St. John chapter 16. No. Never mind. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 18 and verse 10. Proverbs 18 and verse 10. Proverbs 18 and verse 10. Hallelujah. I don't care how it look.
Proverbs
18:10. Amen.
The name of the Lord is a strong tower.
You hear that? So when your faith is in the name of Jesus Christ, what King Solomon said, the name of the Lord is a what?
Strong
tower. So when you come in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I decree my healing. It come to pass. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, you said you shall supply all of my needs according to your richness in glory through in Christ Jesus. The name. Father, I decree, based on your word, that by your stripes I am healed. Not going to be healed, not might be healed, but I am healed. Amen. Your faith in the finished work will override sickness.
Amen.
Your faith in the finished work will override sickness. Hallelujah. Will override it. Will override infirmity. Will override doubt.
Amen.
Will override defeat.
Amen.
Your faith in the name of Jesus. Okay. You hear that? You see that? He says, when you run in their name, you are saved. When you get in that name, you're saved. Hallelujah. In that name, you're saved. And that's what he says. And the righteous, when they are in, and they are saved. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. See, no other name. There's no other name. There's no other name. That's why your prayer must begin in the name of Jesus, and your prayer must end in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Stop that and send a request.
Amen.
Amen. Put a stamp on that name and that envelope. Your petition, and stamp it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Express mail. Go on. Answer back.
Amen.
My God, giving God glory. Amen. Because that name have power. That name have power. That name. See, the devil don't mind you be praying. Oh Lord, blah, 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 blah. Amen. Not going nowhere. He ain't going nowhere. He ain't going nowhere. You ain't mentioned the name. And the Bible says in Philippians 2, verse 9 and 10, that God has highly exalted him and given him a name above